Hello, welcome to my video. This is mucking out on a farm, stables, from the city. First time I've done this, I've been here 3 days. Well, not the first time I've done a stable, but the first time I've ever cleaned up horses. So here we go, gonna try and teach people what I've learned and give you some advice. So, here we go. Now you can see this particular stable isn't that bad, but I will still go through it with you. Sorry about the filming, I'm doing this myself. I don't have a film cameraman to stand there and hold it for me. This is a farm, leaning it up against a brick or a wall or a tilted wall. Come on, camera. Right, so here we go. You will need by the way, I'm not preparing this video at all. I can't be bothered with camera or sound, or this is how it's done. I can't afford to have a cameraman film me and put special music on. So you will need a fork. You will need a broom. You will need a wheelbarrow. Bring a wheelbarrow into the middle of the stable. And here we go. So, now the technique is to only lift, say, where they peed and where they've had a shit. And you'll see and get to know every horse and know where they piss, and they usually do it in the same place. This one isn't that bad at all. And try to save on straw and hay, because it's expensive. And so, you want to take a layer like this, bed of straw, inch underneath, cow, horse shit, cow shit on top, sift it out, chuck your remaining straw and hay to the back. Any you can't pick up that are at the edges, you've got gloves, you're on a farm, use your hands. It's nothing major. I like to grab it by hand sometimes if it's just on the top. It saves disturbing all the straw. Now, this is my technique, and of course, there'll be loads of others. I watch some videos and learn from them. So, here we go again. Slide the fork in, inch underneath. Bed of shit, sift it out, chuck the straw to the back. Now you don't have to get every single bit, because obviously it compacts down, makes a warm layer underneath the bed, and then carry on. Maybe you'll have to dig up some of the fresh straw, but I'll show you that in a minute. Now, this horse isn't that bad, so, see there's a bit of covered up stuff, that's fresh. Of course, I'm doing it different. Everybody else was using a fork, but I don't know, I prefer the hand sometimes. She can grab a big pile. Now, so once you've done that and it's clean, you can move the wheelbarrow out of the way. And then what you want to do, get your fork. This is called banking. So you want to get the hay or the straw and chuck it up to the back of the wall. So there's a bank all the way at the back. Now, any cow shit or horse shit that's heavier than the hay should, if you do it properly, roll back down the bank, and then you can just grab it with your hands like this. Because obviously the horses have to sleep on it. So you have to ask yourself, would you sleep on it? I mean, of course you wouldn't. But if you cleaned all the shit properly, then you probably would find a spot that was not too bad, no? And so scoop everything to the back. Careful not to, if you don't have hay nets and you have straw, try and shift all the straw into the corner so that you don't get it mixed up some more. Maybe a decent bit there. See? Uncover a bit. Get rid of it all. It might be quite deep. You might need to go down. Sometimes you'll have to take a layer off. But, you know, you try not to. Because, that's what keeps the warmth in. And then so, scoop it all to the back, against the wall. Check that there isn't any more anywhere else. Now, a dirty stable should take 10 to 15 minutes. 20 minutes at the max. Depends on the stable. So remove the wheelbarrow. It's usually easier to go backwards with the wheelbarrow. Then you create a nice line and sweep any water that's been spilt for sure. And clear any hay that's been saturated with water or urine. Right. Now you have a clean bed with banks at the side. Now this is the next bit. Now you come back with the bank and just flick it into the, you can flick it into the middle, but you just want to flick it all back in so that it's nice and even. You don't want it piled up at the sides. See, you'll uncover more crap every time. I might be being too picky, maybe. But so here we go. All back into the middle. Now you want to spread it out in a sort of pendulum motion. Make it all easy and even. The only problem you will find is if someone's mucked out the stable before you, you might not have done it properly. Might have just chucked shit up against the wall, and then there's piles of it. So it's usually best to have an arrangement to do your own stables, especially if you're getting paid for it or you're paying someone else to do it, then just get them to do it, because if it's wrong, it's your horse or the person that owns the farm, and you don't want to upset them, because most of them have shotguns. So right, there we go. Now this doesn't really need much more straw put on top, but I am going to put a tiny amount on just to show you. Take your fork out. Don't leave them around horses if they're walking around though, so you get stuck and injured. Use a sack, just can't carry or a wheelbarrow, but my wheelbarrow's full. And then on a stable like this one, you just want like a handful, and then sprinkle it like icing so it looks fresh for the horse. He thinks it's all bedded down. He loves you for it. You check his water. Clean the feeder. And there we go. Stable done. Country style. But we got 20 more. Thanks guys for watching my video, and then hopefully I will do other ones as I go and learn. Putting a bridle on a horse for the first time, that was different. Right, but that's for later.